Heyo, everybody, and welcome back to Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time. I'm a Nick, and on the last episode, we went on a giant Skulltula hunt getting some goodies. And today's episode, we'll actually be putting those sacred stones in the Temple of Time. So we'll just gotta make our way over there, and well, I did not want to talk to you bargain hunters, for Pete's sake. And if you hadn't guessed, the Temple of Time, right over here with a bunch of Seek Stones, blah, blah, blah. Don't think I need to check the time. I think I can see it's daylight, and we'll just go right on in. You get that little cinematic for the very first time you enter. And if you're wondering what the heck this is, you probably also saw it at Lake Hylia. Don't worry about it right now. And let's check this really fast. There are three hollows and an inscription here. Ye who owns three spiritual stones, stand with the Ocarina of Time and play the Song of Time. Well, kind of fucking obvious what it does. Let's do this. Link, isn't that... it's that legendary blade. The Master Sword! Yep, it very well indeed is, and you're probably not gonna hear a ton of commentary from me for a bit, because once we pull this sword, excellent work. As I thought, you held the keys to the Door of Time. You have led me to the gates of the sacred realm. Yes, I owe it all to you, kid. Link. Wake up, Link the Chosen One. I am Rauru, one of the ancient sages. Ages ago, we ancient sages built the Temple of Time to protect the entrance to the sacred realm. This is the Chamber of Sages inside the Temple of Light. The Temple of Light, situated in the very center of the sacred realm, is the last stronghold against Ganondorf's evil forces. The Master Sword, the evil destroying sword that you pulled out of the pedestal of time, was the final key to the sacred realm. Link, don't be alarmed. Look at yourself. Look, Link, you're big now. You've grown up. The Master Sword is a sacred blade which evil ones may never touch. Only one worthy of the title of Hero of Time can pull it from the pedestal of time. However, you were too young to be the Hero of Time. Therefore, your spirit was sealed here for 7 years. And now that you are old enough, the time has come for you to awaken as the Hero of Time. Well, do you understand your destiny? But remember, though you opened the door of time in the name of peace, Ganondorf, the Gerudo King of Thieves, used it to enter this forbidden sacred realm. He obtained the Triforce from the Temple of Light, and with its power, he became the King of Evil. His evil power radiated from the temples of Hyrule, and in 7 short years, it transformed Hyrule into a world of monsters. My power now only has little influence, even in this sacred realm. Namely, this Chamber of Sages. But there is still hope. The power of the sages remains. When the power of all the sages is awakened, the sages' seals will contain all the evil power in the void of the realm. I, Rauru, am one of the sages, and your power to fight together with the sages makes you the Hero of Time. The Hero of Time, chosen by the Master Sword. Keep my spirit with you, and find the power of the other sages and add their might to your own. Find the other sages and save Hyrule. Link, we're back in the Temple of Time. But have 7 years really passed? It looks like you won't be able to use some of the weapons you found as a kid anymore. Let's get out of here! I've been waiting for you, Hero of Time. When evil rules all, an awakening voice from the sacred realm will call those destined to be sages who dwell in the 5 temples. One in a deep forest, one on a high mountain, one under a vast lake, one within the house of the dead, one inside a goddess of the sand. Together with the Hero of Time, the Awakened Ones will bind the evil and return the light of peace to the world. This is the legend of the temples passed down by my people, the Sheikah. So yeah, how do you like that exposition dump? And also, as Navi just said, there are certain items you just can't use anymore because... who knows? Game design... I just don't really know. But it's like, seriously, I can't just wave a stick around as an adult? Are people gonna get judgmental or something? By the way, let's just kinda take a look outside and see. Yep, place has gone to shit. There's a burning ring of fire around Death Mountain now. That's a telltale sign, usually shit's hit the fan. Anyway, let's get moving and hear those sexy adult Link clips. And hey! The market's been burned down and full of re-deads. Here's something I used to do when I was young. Play the sun song and kind of paralyze them. Even though nowadays, I wouldn't really care anymore. But right now, it's just like, well, fuck those guys. And I actually want to empty those bottles at some point, but not right now. So there's actually a couple different things I can do right now. But I think first things first, let's head over to the graveyard in Kakariko Village. And the village will also have changed quite a bit ever since we were there last. Man, I just cannot move faster at the moment. Just, you know, it's nice to have a run button. Anyway, other than the change in instruments for Kakariko Village, all the residents of Hyrule Marketplace now live here. There are shops over there now being occupied. This building's now finished and is now the target practice building. And if you go over here, you'll notice that there's no water in the well. Gee, ain't that fishy. Like, we'll be back there or something. Huh. Anywho, I want to actually talk to you really fast. I bred a new type of miniature Coco. I call it the Pocket Coco. I don't get goosebumps from this baby. Cocos are very good at getting lazy late risers out of bed. Haven't you heard of them before? It makes them very happy to crow, Cuckoo! Especially when it wakes up a very heavy sleeper. However, my Cuckoo is not entirely happy right now. You look like you're good at handling Cuckoos. Here, take this egg. After the Cuckoo hatches, bring it back to me after a while and I'll check it out. I'll check out its mood. What do you think? Will you try? Well, sure. You get the pocket egg! Hello, Adult Line Side Quest. But we'll take care of that in a moment. Let's actually get to that graveyard now, shall we? Alright, and before the other thing I want to show, there are now Poes occupying the graveyard. And your Master Sword does twice the amount of damage the Kokiri Sword ever did. You remember that beam we planted? They sprout into floating platforms. Like, well, how does that even work? And in this box, more Piece of Heart! Hooray! Everybody loves Piece of Heart, and I'll take the recovery, thank you. What I want to do is I want to kill you so you don't harass me while I pull some gravestones. You can just go away. Now, in, you know what? Let's may as well just show this off. The Poe will probably respawn. Whatever. We can enter the Gravekeeper's Hut and see there's a journal. The Gravekeeper's Diary is here. Do you want to read it? Whoever reads this, please enter my grave. I will let you have my stretching, shrinking keepsake. I am waiting for you, Dampe. Okay. Let's, find his grave for something. It's like there's... Yep, totally respawned. There we go. You are dead. Can I actually check this? No. You just have to pull a grave and see if it's right. Except this one's marked by flowers. Which means we can do this and go falling! Welcome to the question mark zone. Please enjoy your stay. Young man, are you fast on your feet? I may not look like it, but I'm confident in my speed. Let's have a race. Follow me if you dare. I will follow you, and please don't do your shenanigans and drop fire on me. That would be nice. Thank you. It slows. Ah, goddammit. Every fucking time. He drops the fire so you can kind of track where he's been, but then shit like that happens and then you become unhappy because he will go behind doors and if you don't get to them in time, fuck. I've done this race plenty of times as a kid and even nowadays, but it's like I'm just doing really sloppy here. Really should not have run into that many fires. Seriously, goddamn. And we'll actually be doing this race again. And there's a very good reason for... Oh, come on! I have to call bull on that one. Come on. Yeah, we're almost there. And if these doors close on you, you get warped back to the beginning and lose half a heart of health. So, keep that in mind. The time of this race was 1:13. Young man, you are very quick to be able to keep up with me. I mean, I would have kept it better if you weren't dropping fires on my ass. As a reward, I'm going to give you my treasure. It's called the Hookshot. Its spring-loaded chain will pull you to any spot where its hook sticks. Doesn't that sound cool? I'm sure it will help you. I live here now, so come back again sometime. I'll give you something cool. One more thing. Be careful on your way back. And now we got our treasure chest. Let's open this bad boy up. We got the hook shot! It's a spring-loaded chain that can cast out the hook things. You can drag stuff to you, or you can pull yourself towards things you can hook. While holding the C button, you can aim with the directional stick and release it, blah blah blah. I am equipping this right away because it's a very essential item. And now we get our first demonstration of a door of time blocks. To move these suckers out of the way, just play the Song of Time within a certain range, and we'll just get the fuck out of your way, just like that. I think these teleport, like, outside of your vision zone or something. Well, whatever you call this, I don't know words. And now we're in the windmill. Doesn't this look fancy? And yeah. I want to do one more thing after I jump on here. And come on. That. I want that piece of heart. Right? Oh, come on. There we go. Phew. Thank you, control stick. That's three pieces. I'm happy with that. Now I want to talk to the windmill man. I'll never forget what happened on that day 7 years ago. It's all that Ocarina kid's fault. Next time he comes around here, I'm gonna mess him up. Gee, an Ocarina, you don't say. What? You've got an Ocarina? What the heck? That reminds me of that time 7 years ago. Back then, a mean kid came here and played a strange song. It messed up this windmill. And we get the infamous Song of Storms. Oh no! A storm again! You played the Ocarina again, didn't you? Huh? And he'll just say that whenever you play the Ocarina, and the windmill spins really, really fast. We'll come back to that later. But for now, I think this is a good cutoff point for today, so on today's episode of Ocarina of Time, we got a plot dump, we have the Master Sword now, and we got ourselves a handy-dandy hookshot. And on the next episode, we're going to do a little more preparing before we go towards the Forest Temple. And so with that, I'm a Nick, and I'll see you guys next time!